Fronto is an exterior version of the popular slats on the market, an innovative solution for facades and ceilings. Thanks to the modern shape of the profile and specially designed joints, we were able to create an original three-dimensional panel that offers many design possibilities. The panels are available in two technologies, the well-known and popular co-extrusion technology and the innovative MAX3 technology, which creates a profile that is extremely resistant to mechanical damage and large temperature fluctuations. Fronto's wide range of options and solutions allows you to create a unique image for your home. For a proper installation, you will need basic tools, such as a spirit level, tape measure, square, scissors, hammer, knife, pencil, drill, and power tools, such as a drill driver and chop saw. For sawing, a saw blade designed for cutting aluminium will be best. Panels can be cut with a chop saw, circular blade, or angle grinder. Depending on the structure on which the installation will be carried out, you will need screws for wood or metal. Detailed installation instructions, available in each package and on the website, will be an indispensable aid. The first step in facade installation is the preparation of the substructure. This is a labor-intensive operation that takes up to 70 to 80% of the total installation. However, a correctly executed substructure guarantees the correct completion of the facade and an excellent end result. The substructure also allows for adequate air circulation between the wall and the facade. For this purpose, the substructure must be installed at a height of at least 50 mm from ground level and a space of approximately 20 mm at the top edge of the wall. The same values should be maintained for the installation of finishing trims and panels. For the substructure, you can use wooden battens or metal profiles. The spacing between the battens or profiles to which the panels will be directly fixed should be a maximum of 40 cm from center to center of the batten or profile. To prepare a wooden frame, use wooden battens, which should be made of good quality wood, not free, impregnated, and with a moisture content of 15 to 17%. The battens should have dimensions of at least 30 by 22 mm. Use 35 mm screws for wood to fix the panels to the wooden substructure. First, install the horizontal battens along the length of the building, spacing them according to the type of insulation used. Then fill the space between the battens with insulating material and place the vapor barrier membrane on top. If you plan to install the panels horizontally, the next step is to install the vertical battens, which will be the base for installing the panels and provide ventilation space between the wall and the panels. Install them at a maximum distance of 40 cm from the center to the center of the batten. If you plan to install the panels vertically, the vertical battens installed on the insulation layer may have a spacing of more than 40 cm, as the horizontal battens will be fixed to them, which will serve as a base for the installation of the panels. To prepare a metal frame, use CD100 profiles with a height of 48 mm or CD60 profiles with a height of 27 mm. When installing horizontally, the preparation of the metal frame starts with the fastening of the fastening hooks, which enable the vertical installation of the metal profiles to the wall with a maximum distance of 40 cm from the center to the center of the profile. Next, apply thermal insulation to the attached hook and puncture it. A vapor barrier membrane is applied to the thermal insulation, and then metal profiles are attached to the fastening hooks, which will serve as a base for installing the Fronto panels horizontally and at the same time ensure adequate ventilation between the wall and the panels. The excess hooks are bent over, with the ends slightly hammered into the insulation, so that it adheres properly to the wall. If you plan to install the panels vertically, a layer of profiles laid horizontally with a maximum distance of 40 cm between them must be installed on top of the vertical profiles, which in this case can be spaced more than 40 cm apart. The installation of the Fronto panels is made easier by a series of matching trims. First is the SV11.5 lower ventilation trim, which prevents vermin and dirt from getting under the surface of the facade, and the SV11 starting trim, which is necessary to start the installation. Next is the SV12 outer corner and the SV13 inner corner. The SV15J trim is very commonly used for finishing the edges at the top and side of the wall, as well as in the inner corners for vertical installation. The SV18 connector, on the other hand, is used for joining panels laid horizontally along their length. The need for adequate expansion joints is related to the expansion and contraction of the panels under the influence of the ambient temperature. The expansion joints depend on the ambient conditions and are specified for each country in the installation instructions available on the website. In the absence of large daily temperature differences, an approximately 10mm expansion gap at each end of the wall is sufficient. A so-called fixing point is only used when the panels are installed vertically to stabilize the direction of contraction and expansion due to the ambient temperature. For the fixing point, it is best to choose the second batten from the top or the middle batten. This will prevent the panel from moving uncontrollably. Depending on how the mounting hole aligns with the batten, the following fixing methods are possible. At the edge of the mounting hole, between the mounting holes, or at the edges of the adjacent mounting holes. Panel is fixed by screwing the screws into the mounting holes. Try to keep a distance of approximately 10mm from the side edges of the mounting hole and do not tighten them completely, leaving a gap so the panel can move. For vertical installation, the Fronto panels are fixed to horizontal profiles or, as in our case, to wooden substructure battens. Before starting to install the panels, level and screw on the trims. The SV11 starting trim at the bottom of the wall is not used for vertical installation. This is replaced by the SV15 trim, in which several holes must be drilled for water drainage. The panels should be installed from left to right. Measure the required length of the panel, remembering to keep a suitable expansion joint in the trims. Cut the first panel to length and slide it into the trim. Level and then lock the panel with two screws on the second batten from the top. On the other battens, fasten the screws as standard in the middle of the mounting holes and do not tighten them all the way. Each successive panel is hooked over the edge of the previous one, which makes the click lock easier, and also lock it onto the second batten from the top. The last panel also often needs trimming. In this case, it is to cut the required width. The cut lock can be used to support the cut edge. Before installing the last panel, it is advisable to make additional perforations along its final edge to act as hooks to prevent the panel from falling out of the trim. Once the installation is complete, spray the panels with anti-static fluid and wipe down to clean the finished facade of dirt and dust. For horizontal installation, the Fronto panels are fixed to vertically laid battens, or in this case, to metal substructures. The actual installation of the slats starts with the leveling and fitting of the vertical trims. followed by the installation of the lower ventilation trim and the SV11 starting trim between them. All the trims must be accurately leveled using a spirit level to ensure that the panels are installed correctly. When determining the length to which the panels must be cut, remember to maintain the correct expansion gap in the trim. The panels should be installed from the bottom up. The first panel is clipped into the starting trim and slid into the vertical trims. It is very important that the panel can move in the trims. To do this, position it more or less in the middle, for example, with the same expansion gap on one side and on the other. Then fasten the panel with screws. Try to place the screws in the middle of the mounting hole and do not tighten them to allow the panel to move. The panel of the next layer slides into the preceding panel. The panel is correctly installed when you hear the distinctive click of the lock. Thanks to the click locks, once assembled, the panel is firmly in place and will not fall down. This allows you to reach freely for tools and install the panel without additional assistance. Each subsequent panel is installed in the same way. The slats are joined lengthways using the SV18 connector. Joining with this connector will be necessary for wall lengths of more than 3 meters. The joint must be planned before fitting, and the connector fitted on a double or, if necessary, triple batten. The last panel often does not fit in its entirety. Therefore, you must measure the distance between the edge of the lock and the inside of the trim pocket and cut it to height accordingly. Use the cut-off lock as a support and place it in the SV15 trim. For finishing window and door recesses, use an SV12 outer corner and an SV15 universal trim. At the inner and outer edges of the recess, install the battens on profiles to which the trim will be fixed. At the joint between a wall and a window, or between a wall and a door frame, install the SV15 trim on both sides and on top. Similarly, install the SV12 outer corner on the outer edge of the recess. The outer corner sections need to be prepared so that water can flow into the drainage channels. For this, you first need to get the dimensions. In the case of the internal dimension, 1 centimeter must be added on each side for the overlap. This is what correctly cut corners should look like. They are connected in such a way that water can drain away from the facade. The prepared trims are attached to the substructure at the outer edge of the recess. Once they have been secured, it is enough to place the panels cut to length in the pockets of the trims. When determining the length of the sections, remember the expansion joints. Fronto slats can be installed in a recess as a soffit, provided that it is protected from direct sunlight. For this installation, a substructure with a maximum of 40 cm spacing between wooden battens or metal profiles from center to center is required. It is essential that the substructure is suitably level. Make sure that the right and left edge battens and the wall side battens are spaced away from the edge, depending on the type of installation on adjacent walls. This will enable the panels to be properly secured. If you intend to lay the panels along the recess, then install the substructure profiles or battens as for horizontal installation. If across the recess, then install the profiles or battens as for vertical installation. Where there is a need for edge finishing, SV15 battens should be used. It is possible to install lighting in the ceiling-mounted panels, but this should be planned during the substructure preparation stage. Electrical cables must be routed to the selected locations and holes drilled in the panels. The panels should be cut to length, with the expansion joints in the trims. Insert the first panel into the trims and screw it to the substructure so that it can move. Each subsequent panel is installed in the same way. Feed the cables for the lights through the pre-drilled holes. The last panel should be cut to the required width, inserted into the trims, and clicked into the lock. Finally, install the lights in the panels. After screwing the panels onto the ceiling, install the panels on the walls. In order to obtain a smooth transition from the ceiling to the wall, the panels on the wall have to be fitted in such a way that the joints meet in the same place. Knowing how to properly join trims together makes it possible to install the facade more aesthetically and to make use of the trim sections. To join an SV15 trim, cut off approximately 5 cm of the trim section with the mounting holes and the curved edge of the trim and push the cut end into the other trim section. For the SV12 outer corners, cut out the slotted edge and the trim pocket at the end of one section of the trim, and in the other section, cut the outer edges of the trim at an angle and then slide one trim into the other. For an aesthetically pleasing joint between the horizontal and the vertical trim, the upper edge of the horizontal trim should be cut out, bent, and inserted into the pocket of the vertical trim. This video shows general rules and instructions for installation. It is important to read the full installation instructions on the website, as failure to do so may invalidate the warranty.